Good morning. We're here to talk about our 40 Not 50 campaign. As you probably know, a recent government task force is recommending that women start screening mammograms at age 50. We know this could lead to tragedy. Today, Kelly and Dave are here as our guests to talk about Kelly's experience with having been diagnosed with breast cancer at a young age. Kelly, how did it come about that they found your cancer at such a young age?
Well, Dr. West, I was 36 years old. Back in 2004 when I was diagnosed, I didn't know anybody with breast cancer. I was in seeing another doctor having another procedure done, and he asked for me to have a mammogram. So I thought, okay, great. Well, that's how it all started. And from there, I was told I had breast cancer. I was told that I needed to have a mastectomy immediately. And from there, I decided that, you know what, I need to take this into my own hands and be my own advocate. So I started asking questions and doing research, and that's when I found you.
Well, thank you. And we know that things did go very well for you. You did catch an early cancer, but you were 36, and you weren't planning on getting a mammogram. It just so happened that one of your doctors was very proactive about it, said, let's get a baseline mammogram at this point in time, and that showed...
That's right. It was a very small cancer, so you know, I was very fortunate that it was caught when it was caught. But, you know, nonetheless, I'm still 36. My husband and I had just gotten married. 2 years we had been married, and we were starting to plan for a family, and then this happens. So,
what was your response when they told her she had a spot in the mammogram they were worried about?
Well, obviously, as anybody else, it's shocking.
Yeah.
And especially at her age of 36, as she mentioned, we'd only been married for 2 years. And it's a game changer.
Yeah.
You know, to imagine that they would not have women get mammograms prior to 40 with our experience and the journey that we've been on is absolutely crazy. I mean, it changed our lives. We did get married a little bit later in life, as more and more people are doing so, you know, today. But, you know, it's put off a lot of things as far as having a family and, you know, changed kind of the focus. But the most important thing is that Kelly found you and you know, BreastLink, and was able to, you know, she's have an operation, and she's healthy now, and she's doing well.
Well, the story has a great ending, but one could not help but think about what happens if, say, you didn't have a mammogram. It's slow-growing cancer, but between 36 and 50, you've got 14 years.
That's right.
We would expect that cancer to become more aggressive with time, to grow.
Right.
Maybe they would detect it early, maybe you'd feel a lump in an early time, but maybe not. It's a form of Russian roulette. You don't know what to say. However, if you catch it at a small state like this, you can save your breasts, you don't have to have a lot of aggressive therapy, you're going to do well and end up a happy camper. And so you can imagine my frustration when we see so many young women, and you're involved in our volunteer support program, so you're seeing. Tell me about some of the other women you're seeing at young ages.
I see so many young women with breast cancer, and it's staggering. The numbers are staggering, and you know, I think as a young woman, you know, this isn't an old person's disease anymore.
No.
And I think younger women are starting to realize that. And the more that we can do to help educate these younger women, you know, and teach them about, you know, self-exams and early detection, it's going to save a lot of lives. But I can't imagine if a woman's not able to get a mammogram until they're 50. Mm-hmm. I mean, if that happened to me, it would be a different story right now.
Yeah.
It would definitely be a different conversation.
Well, I think every bit of evidence we see, both clinically when we see our patients, when we see patients with more advanced cancer, it's typical that they haven't had a mammogram either ever or hadn't had one for several years. We see a large number of patients that we follow regularly with yearly mammograms, and when we pick up those cancers, they're virtually always early stage breast cancer. We can almost always save the breast. We can usually avoid chemotherapy. You know, if you start at 50, you're going to miss the opportunity to save lives. And so I think your case is so classic. In fact, you're under 40. Nobody's absolutely saying every woman under 40 should start yearly, so you were kind of lucky in that, but I've had a large number of patients. The other thing for women under 40 that we most typically use is breast self-exam. Women under 40 have really no screening modality that's you were just lucky because somebody pushed the envelope a little bit. But for the average woman, it's hard to know what to tell them to do. I believe it's with you 100%, learning how to do self-exam with confidence, doing it regularly. If you detect a change, bring it to a doctor that will listen to you, examine you, do a diagnostic ultrasound, do extra views to make sure they know exactly what they've got. And if it's not absolutely certain that it's benign, then you need a needle core biopsy. But so often the doctors say, well, you know, you're under 40, it's not your family, right. You're just, you know, probably just hormones. And so they have a million excuses. So women need to empower themselves. And you're the perfect example because you found out there was a problem, but you didn't just say, okay, you're going to have your breast removed. You said, well, let's see what the alternatives are. You got this other opinion. You learned, you studied, and you asked the right questions.
That's right.
And here you are today because of it. I think your story is so, so important because you can't help but look at you at your relatively young age and say that, you know, it's been 16 years. Had we not seen that, who knows what the story would be right
now. That's right.
Dave, you know, looking back on it, I mean, you must have had these thoughts going on over and over. How has it influenced your thinking?
Well, my thought with it is, you know, now revisiting the topic is, you know, you wonder if she'd be here now.
Yeah.
I mean, she was 36 years old. She's very young. It was the last thing that was on our mind.
Yeah.
The absolute last thing. But it is what you have to deal with in life. And, you know, if to think that she would have waited till she was 50, because it was not detectable. Mm-hmm. You know, as far as just by a self-exam.
It was basically, I was told it was calcifications. Mm-hmm. And not only was I told it was calcifications, but I was also told that they were pretty sure that it was just that, mm-hmm. and that it was not cancer. Yeah. And asked me if I wanted to have a biopsy for peace of mind.
Hmm.
And I said, yeah, of course. And mm-hmm. I remember asking the mammographer, what would you do if you were me? Mm-hmm. And she says, well, I'm a survivor myself. I've had a double mastectomy. They call me the bulldog in the office. I would, of course, have a biopsy. So I said, well, let's do it. And mm-hmm. I remember calling him from the car. I'm here. It looks like I'm going to have a biopsy. I'm scared. You know, I'm trying to take some deep breaths. And to make a long story short, I got a call the next morning on my cell phone from the mammographer, from her cell phone, telling me that she was shocked, but it came back positive.
Mm.
So, you know, shocking to say the least.
Yeah.
And I remember specifically asking when I decided that I needed to do some research and find the surgeon that was for me, because this is important, and having that relationship with your doctor, like I have with you. I found your name through a couple of referrals, and I remember calling your office on a Friday. And I said, I'd like to make an appointment, a consultation appointment with Dr. West. He comes highly, highly recommended. And they said, okay, great, we'll check the schedule and try to get you in. And she said, we'd like to try to get you in next Monday, but the schedule's full. Can we call you and call you back? And I said, absolutely. So I left my cell phone number. About an hour later, and I don't know if you remember this because you have so many patients, but you called me on my cell phone.
I do remember.
And you said, hi, Kelly, this is Dr. West. I understand that you've just been diagnosed with breast cancer, and I want you to come in on Monday morning. Can you come in at 7 a.m. before I start surgeries, and I will meet with you? And I was so pleasantly surprised that a doctor would actually call me on my cell phone and ask me to come in. And you said, this is so important, you said, grab a pen and paper right now. I want you to take down my cell phone number. Because I want you to have this over the weekend, that if in case you get scared or nervous or you have questions, I want you to be able to call me over the weekend.
That is
important for any woman to have that assurance that their doctor cares and is concerned and knows what they're going through. And so I want you to know I appreciate that.
Well, people say, when are you going to retire? How could I possibly ever retire with this amount of positive feedback? I think the story is just classic. We see it over and over again. Women under 50 who are diagnosed with breast cancer. We have to do more, not less. We need to get more aggressive, use better technology, find who is high risk and treat them even more aggressively. But here's the good news. If we apply this new technology, this life-saving technology, we're going to save more lives. We're going to avoid women with advanced cancer needing chemotherapy, mastectomies, and having recurrences. We have the opportunity to really move forward, but we need to have the public get behind this program of 40 not 50 and get these women, have their mammograms yearly, and catch breast cancer when it's early, treatable, and curable.